Before I get into this video, if you're looking for cheap game keys, check out Instant Gaming. I bought a lot of games from there and they really do have the cheapest prices. Hey, what's up guys, so just like 750 Ti from the last video, 970 was also released in 2014. But unlike 750 Ti, it could run, or it still can, Crysis 3 at 1080p max settings with playable frame rate. Oh yes, the undying, but can it run Crysis Beam? But we're not here today to see how it performs in a game from 2013, but rather to see how it performs in games from this year, 2019, among which are Sekiro, Shadows Die Twice, and Wolfenstein Youngblood, a game that came out just 2 weeks ago. I know a lot of you still own this card and are probably wondering if it's time to upgrade to something better and newer like GTA 1660. So let's take a quick look at the specs before getting into benchmarks. 4GB of VRAM, which is I guess enough if you're gaming at 1080p. It also consumes more power than 1660, which was of course expected since the 970 is a really old card. Without further ado, let's see how it compares to newer GPUs. Enjoy! So it's definitely not possible anymore to get 60fps with max settings in every game, but lowering some settings will for sure get you that smooth frame rate. So the conclusion here is you don't really have to rush with upgrading it. I guess it mainly depends on how much money you have in your wallet. So that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm looking forward to seeing your opinion down in the comment section. Also feel free to leave a like and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed. Hope you have a nice day and see you in the next video.